हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माय सेल्फ प्रोफेसर शांताय गुरुमठ, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ बॉटनी, एमजीवीसी आर्ट्स कॉमर्स एंड साइंस कॉलेज मुद्दे बिहार, कर्नाटक स्टेट. सो टुडेज क्लास वी डिस्कस अबाउट पार्ट 6 ब्रायोफाइट्स. द बेस्ट एग्जांपल इज फिनेरिया. द फिनेरिया कम्स अंडर डिवीजन ब्रायोफाइटा, क्लास ब्रायोप्सिडा, ऑर्डर फिनेरियलस, फैमिली फिनेरियसी, द जीनस फिनेरिया. The Fineria is a bryophyte. It is included under the class Bryopsida or Musai. It is commonly known as cord moss. The name Fineria was derived from a Latin word. Funis means rope. Fineria is cosmopolitan in distribution. It is found in tropical and temperate zones of the world. It grows well in moist, shady places. Plant grown dense patches of bright green color. They live on the damp soil, river banks, moist rocks, moist walls, burnt humid soils, and on tree trunks. Then we discuss about the external structure of Fineria. The Fineria is a moss plant. It is a bryophyte. The plant body consists of stem, leaves, and rhizoids. It grows up to 3 cm height. The stem is erect and branched. The branching is monopodial and extra axillary. The branch arises from the lower portion. See friends, this is the structure of Fineria thallus. Of the stem is green and photosynthetic. The leaves are arranged spirally on the stem. They are scattered at the base of the stem and crowded near the apex. The leaves are sessile and more or less ovate. They have a distinct midrib but not lateral veins. The base of the stem is fixed on the substratum by rhizoids. The rhizoids are branched and multicellular. Then we discuss about the internal structure of stem. TS of stem shows three distinct regions: outer epidermis, middle cortex, and inner central cylinder. First we discuss about outer epidermis. The epidermis is single-layered. The cells contain chloroplasts, and so they can do photosynthesis. Stomata and cuticle are absent in the epidermis. Next, we discuss about middle cortex. The cortex lies between the epidermis and central cylinder. It is multilayered and parenchymatous. The outer cortical cells of mature stem are thick-walled, but the inner cortical cells are thin-walled. The cortex is storage and function. See friends, this is the internal structure of stem. The inner central cylinder, it is a core of vertically elongated cells. The cells are thin-walled and colorless, and they have no protoplasm. It serves as a mechanical tissue. True vascular bundles are absent. It also serves as conductive and storage tissue. Next, we discuss about the internal structure of leaf. TS of leaf shows single-layered wing or lamina and a midrib. The cells of the wing are large and chloranchymatous. The marginal cells are smaller in size. All cells of the wing are photosynthetic. The midrib occurs at the middle of the wing. It is several cells thick and bounded by upper epidermis and lower epidermis. The cells are thick-walled. In the center of the midrib, there is a small central cylinder. It is composed of elongated, thick-walled cells. It provides mechanical support to the leaf and serves as conducting strand. Next friends, we discuss about the reproduction in Fineria. In Fineria, reproduction takes place by two methods. First one is by vegetative reproduction and another one is sexual reproduction. First we discuss about vegetative reproduction. First method is secondary protonema. The secondary protonema is green filamentous structure. It develops from injured portion of the stem, leaves and rhizoids of the gametophyte. Many small buds develop from the secondary protonema. The buds grow into new gametophore or gametophytes. Next method, by bulbils. The bulbils are small resting buds arising from the rhizoids of and protonema. They resume growth during favorable season and produce filamentous protonema. The protonema produces many small buds. Each bud then develops into a gametophores or gametophyte. Next method is by gimme. Gimme are multicellular bud-like structures. They are produced at the tip of leaves or stem or rhizoids. The detached gimme directly develop into new gametophytic plants. Lastly, we discuss about apospory. Green protonemal filaments arise from the injured part of the sporophyte. Since the protonema is derived from the sporophytic tissue, they are diploid. They give rise to a diploid gametophyte. Next friends, we discuss about sexual reproduction in Fanaria. In Fanaria, sexual reproduction is oogamous type. The gametophyte is homothallic or monoecious. The male and female sex organs are produced in the different branches but of the same plant. Enthridia. The male sex organ are called enthridia. Enthridia are produced in cluster at the tip of the leafy shoot. This leafy shoot is known as enthridial branch or male branch. The enthridial branch is about 1 cm in height. The enthridia are surrounded by a rosette of leaves forming a perichecium. The enthridia together with the perichecial form the moss male flower. The tip of the enthridial branch is convex. The enthridia are erect and reddish brown or orange in color. See friends, this is the structure of enthridia. This is the enthridial branch along with number of paraphyses. Next we discuss about the mature enthridium. It is a club shaped, borne on stalk. The main body contains a mass of spermatogenesis cells surrounded by a layer of jacket cells. Next we discuss about the archegonia. The gametophyte bearing archegonia is called as a female branch. It arises from the base of male branch. The apex of the branch flattened into a receptacle on which archegonia develop in cluster in interrupted paraphyses. See friends, this is the female branch with the number of archegonia along with paraphyses. Next, the structure of archegonium. A mature archegonium is a flask shaped which is born on a short stalk. It has a basal swollen part, the venter and elongated neck. The venter is surrounded by a two-layered jacket, whereas the around the neck is a single layer. Next, we discuss about fertilization. Dehiscence of enthridium is done by the rain or dew drops of the apical end of male branch. The jacket cells imbibe water and split up from the operculum, forming a small pore. The male gametes move in a mass. At the same time, the neck canal and ventral canal cell disintegrate to form a mucilage. It absorbs moisture and swells up and forces the disintegration of apical cell of neck. The male sperms attracted chemotactically, and after this fertilization takes place, the zygote enlarges in size to fill up a venter and to form protective sheath called calyptra around the sporogonium. Next friends, we discuss about the sporogonium. The sporophyte in Fanaria is commonly called as sporogonium. Spores are produced by meiosis. Structure of sporogonium. It is born at the end of female branch. It has the following parts. The first one is massive foot, long seta. Next, pear-shaped capsule. The first part is foot. The foot is embedded in the apical tissue or female branch. It absorbs water and nutrients from the gametophyte. Next part is ceta. The ceta is long and it carries capsule at the apex. It consists of central conducting strand composed of thin-walled cells surrounded by a cortex, epidermis and covered by cuticle. See friends, this is the sporophyte of Fineria. It's the vertical section of capsule. Next, we discuss about the capsule. It is a pear-shaped and highly organized spore-producing structure. A young stage, it is green, but as it matures, it turns dark brown. The apical part of capsule is covered by remains a ruptured calyptra. The capsule has considerable tissue differentiation. Capsule has three distinct parts. First one is apophysis. It is a swollen, sterile region of capsule. The wall is made up of epidermis that contains stomata. Below this, a photosynthetic spongy layer is present that has intercellular spaces. In the center, a strand of thin-walled, vertically elongated cells are present that are conducting. Next, we discuss about theca. Central part of capsule, sterile central part called as columella. Columella is surrounded by a barrel-shaped spore sac that contains spore mother cells. Outer these sac, there is a wide air space called as trabeculae that connects capsule wall to the spore sac, the wall of spore sac. The wall of theca consists of epidermis, hypodermis and two-celled thick photosynthetic spongy layer. Next, we discuss about operculum. The conical cap like terminal region of capsule, it consists of 3 to 4 layered thin-walled cells covered with epidermis. Below the operculum is peristome. It consists of 16 long doubled incurved teeth and 16 thin-walled inner segments. The peristome is attached to the ring of thin-walled cells that form a rim of capsule. The peristome teeth is hygroscopic and responded to the slight change in moisture. The annulus lower layers, two layers of cells are thin-walled and constitute annulus. The degeneration of annulus results in losing and dropping of operculum. Lastly, we discuss about the life cycle of Fineria. The life cycle of Fineria is holodiplontic type. In the life cycle, free-living haploid gametophyte alternates with a semi-sporophytic diploid sporogonium, means sporophyte. In this type, alternation of generation is called heteromorphic or heterologous. In Fineria, the main plant body is free-living gametophyte, means N, which exists in two forms, that is protonema, means juvenile gametophyte, and a leafy gametophyte is an adult gametophyte. See friends, this is the life cycle of Fineria. The Fineria plant itself is gametophyte and it produces two branches. One is male branch and female branch. Male branch bears Enthridia and female branch bears Archegonia. The Enthridia produces the sperms and Archegonia produces the egg. Then fertilization takes place. Then there is a formation of a zygote. Then zygote by further division to form the sporophyte. The mature sporophyte is foot, ceta and capsule. The capsule bears the fertile region is spore mother cells. The spore mother cells by the production of meiosis to produce the haploid spores. Then spore germination and to produce the young gametophyte and mature gametophyte. See friends, this is the life cycle of Fineria. Okay, thank you friends. We meet in the next video.